Hey guys, today's video is about model evaluation. We've talked about K-fold cross-validation last time. Today we are going to focus on stratified K-fold cross-validation. Just for the record, we'll abbreviate cross-validation as CV from now on. Stratified K-fold CV is an extension of K-fold CV and is specifically designed for imbalanced dataset. The basic procedure is the same, so let's review the procedure of K-fold CV. First, we divide the whole dataset into K-folds with equal size. Second, we perform the normal training and evaluation process using one fold as testing set and the remaining folds as training set. Then, step 2 is repeated K times, and each time, we use a different fold as testing set. Last, we take the average of all the accuracies or other evaluation measures we calculated in step 3 and present this average number as the model's final performance. The only difference between normal K-fold CV and stratified K-fold CV is in step 1. For normal K-fold CV, we randomly split the data, but for stratified K-fold CV, we manually make the class distribution in each fold roughly the same as the original data. To have a concrete idea, let's look at an example. Say we have this imbalanced dataset, which has 80 data points in class 0, 20 data points in class 1. Suppose k equals to 4 and we randomly split the data, we might end up with such different class distribution in each fold. In specific, two folds don't even have data from class 1, and one fold contains most of the data from class 1. So, if the first fold is used as the testing set, then the training set will contain only a few samples from class 1. Obviously, the model won't be able to train properly. Therefore, we'd like to have the same class distribution among the folds. And this is what stratified K-fold CV tries to achieve. To illustrate, stratified K-fold CV should generate a split like this. Each fold has 20 samples from class 0, 5 samples from class 1. The distribution is exactly the same as the original data. Although we don't always get the exact same distribution, roughly the same is also acceptable. Let's talk about the pros and cons. Just like the normal K-fold CV, the whole dataset is used for both training and testing, so we didn't waste any data. Moreover, the evaluation result has low bias because of the resampling procedure. Nevertheless, stratified K-fold CV is suitable for imbalanced datasets, which is a weakness of normal K-fold CV. But it's still not suitable for time series data, because even if we maintain the class distribution, we didn't preserve the ordering of the data. Alright, that's the introduction to stratified K-fold CV. Thank you for watching my video and hope you enjoyed it.